और ऐसा लास्ट टॉपिक व्हाट वी वर डिस्कसिंग, अदर्स ऑल ऑन योर वीडियोस प्लीज, आई एम रिपीटली सेइंग इट, ओके विष्णुप्रिया, व्हाट वाज द लास्ट टॉपिक वी कवर्ड, जस्ट गिव मी व्हाट वी वर डूइंग.
Equations of motion, we just started that.
Equations of motion, we have not done any problem or nothing like that.
No, just give that equations.
Three relations, okay. So we continue with it. Okay, all of you. So once again, you must have forgotten about that. So we are moving on to equations of motion. Derivation, you don't have to study. In the textbook, there's a big derivation is given. You don't have to study. We only learned the three equations of motion. And each equation of motion has given a name. The first equation, we call it velocity-time relation. This is what we simply mentioned, but we did not. Can you tell Hadidi what is the velocity-time relation we have written in the book?
V is equal to u plus at.
Okay, v is equal to u plus at. Okay. Haya, give me the position time relation. Position time relation. What's that equation? Second equation of motion is known as
position. Plus half at square.
Yes, s is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay. What was the third equation of motion? Ashik, what was the third equation of motion? Position velocity relation.
Gamma Yosef Sandler plus. Yosef Sandler.
You were not there in the class.
No, ma'am.
Okay, Surya Krishna.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me the third equation of motion.
V square minus u square is equal to 2as.
Yeah, v square. Everyone, just study now only these three equations. Okay, 1 minute I'll give you. I'll be asking you afterwards. Okay. Okay. Meghna, give me velocity time relation.
V is equal to u plus at.
Okay. Lolita, what is v? What is v? V stands for which? Are you saying something, Lalita? Okay, find the velocity. Is that you said? Find the velocity. Is that you said? Okay. Savio, what is a? Savio, what is a?
Acceleration.
Acceleration. Okay, good. What is u? Hence, T, what is u? What velocity u? V, final velocity. So, what is u? H, Hence, Steve, are you listening to me? V is final velocity. So what is U?
Displacement.
U is displacement. Melvin, what is U?
Initial velocity.
Yes, initial velocity. What is U? This is we are learning from April onwards, hence Steve. V is final, U is initial velocity, A is acceleration. Okay. Very good. Anchita, Benny, what is, give me position time relation. Position time relation. Just now I told you, no, I give 1 minute, study that. Did you do that? Position time relation.
Ma'am, I can't do that.
Okay. Fia Harris, position time relation.
S is equal to ut plus half ab
at square. Okay, so is equal to ut plus half at square. What is S, Vishnu? S stands for what? S.
Ma'am?
S. The letter S stands for what? S stands for? Afzana?
Speed.
No, no speed. Speed is velocity. Speed and velocity same letter. S stands
displacement.
For? Displacement. Displacement. Time. Not time. Displacement. S stands for displacement or distance. And T stands for time. Clear? Okay, Adidev, give position velocity relation.
Yes, ma'am.
Give position velocity relation.
S is equal to ut plus half at square.
Did you hear? I said position velocity relation.
V square minus u square is equal to a,
yes.
2
v as. Squared minus, yeah, correct. V squared minus u square 2 as. That is not time term in that. That's a position velocity relation. Velocity time. So there is t is there. Position time. There is t is there. Okay. Okay, so now using, we will do one problem. All of you write. A train.
Yes, ma'am. I mean lecture notes.
Yeah, lecture notes enough. So first problem under this, using this. A train starting from Brest. A train starting from Rest means stationary position. Attains a velocity. Attains a velocity of 72 km/h. 72 km/h in 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Find number one, uniform acceleration. Find uniform acceleration. Second question, second part, the distance. The distance traveled by the train. Okay. Hope everyone complete that.
Yeah. Ma'am. No.
Okay. I wait. Okay, students. So the first thing is to read the question once again and get the clue. What are the things are given? You have in your mind all these equations. So for according to the question, we have to use either of these three equations. So that is how we have to solve. So let us now go back to the question once again. A train starting from rest. From rest means it is starting from zero. That means initial velocity of the train is zero. Correct? At rest. Then after some time, what will happen? It attains the velocity. How much? Since it is a train. So in 1 hour, 72 kilometer. Because it is that much fast. In 5 minutes. Now here is the problem. In SI unit, we have to get the answer in meter per second. And here, the velocity is given kilometer per hour. What type of velocity? Initial velocity is zero. So 72 kilometer per hour will be. What will be that velocity? What is 72 kilometer per hour? Initial velocity is zero because it is starting from rest. So what will
final
be?
Velocity.
Final velocity. In how much time it got that velocity?
Five minutes.
5 minutes. That means minutes also we need to change. Minutes also we need to change. We cannot do the problem. So what is the first step? First thing to find out the acceleration. Okay. So you already learned in acceleration equation. You can use both ways. One is by using equation of motion. That is V is equal to U plus AT, or you can also use the equation what we learned this. From this equation you are getting this. If you just manipulate this equation, you will get the same equation here. That is A is equal to B minus UT, U by T. If you manipulate this equation, you will get AT is equal to V minus U. Therefore, V is equal to U plus AT. So same equation is this. There's no change. Okay. So we have to find out V. Since train is starting from rest, we can zero. Write initial velocity zero. Final velocity, it is given 72 kilometer per hour. So we need to convert it into meter per second. How do we convert? We have learned. How do we convert? Aman, on your video. Aman, Shakir, all of you. Okay. Hadi, Pia Harris, Emil Jacob, all the videos are off. Abzana, Gurujit. Okay, John Samuel. Yeah, John Samuel, tell me, how do we convert kilometer per hour into meter per second? We have already learned, no? We have to multiply with what? Anyone remembers? 1
by 3.
Into 5 by
18.
Yeah, correct. So, 72 and 18. So V is equal to 72 into 5 by 18. 72 into 5 by 18. With what we get? Tell me that answer. 18 into, I think, 4. Just do. 18 into 4, you may get 72. Just try. 18 into 4.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So your answer is? What is now final velocity in meter per second? 4 into 20. 5. 20. And what is the time? Time is 5 minutes, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes. 5 minutes change into second. So you will get 300
seconds.
Yeah. Now just substitute equation. That is first equation of motion. 20 is equal to u plus 80. 0 plus a into 300. So u is 0. So that term is gone. So what you're getting now in max 300 a is equal to 20. Therefore a is equal to 20 by 300. Under 100 get cancelled, 2 by 30. Get me answer in decimal. Or you can, for the time being, what is the answer? 2 by 30 means make it to small fraction. 2 by 30.
Ma'am, 20 equals to 15.
1 by 15. So you are getting acceleration is 1 by 15 meter per second square. We need to make into decimals, but now for our convenience we are just writing, because we need to use this for next problem. So 1 by 15 meter per second square. Clear? Okay, shall we go to second part of the question? Second part of the question, the distance traveled by the train. So which equation we can use in this, which equation? There are so many equations are there. Which equation can be used here?
Second
equation. Okay, we can also use the third equation. There is no problem. But it is square and all. It may have complicated. You can make into third. But I think better we use the third equation more easy, because u squared is equal to 0. U squared is equal to going to be 0. So it become little more easy for you, I think so. Say any 2 or 3 we can use. Why? Because you know the time. You also use this also. Okay, you can use the third equation for our convenience. Okay, that's up to you which equation you have to use. So here at present I am using the third equation of motion. So that is v squared minus u squared is equal to 2s. V squared means 20 square, 0 square. 2 into, this is why I told not to make into decimal, because we can cancel here. Into s. We have to calculate what? Distance. Correct? So 20 square is equal to
400.
Yeah. 2 into 15. Yes. 400. Yeah. So 400 into 15 is equal to 2s. Cross multiply you can use, no? So this 15 can be multiplied with the 400. So 2s. Now, can we find out now? Yes. Symbol now. Yeah. Symbol now. If you use this equation, it is going to be a little more symbol for you. Other equation also use half 80 square. No problem for it. Give me the answer. 400 into 15 by 2.
3000.
6,000. Will you get that? 2 and 400 can be cancelled, no, my dear.
3,000.
Yes. 3,000. It's a symbol. Don't simply without careless mistake. Don't make careless mistake. 3,000. Here, 200 into 50. Symbol. 3,000 meter. Okay. Is there anyone did not understand this problem? So from where we start? Yeah, we go back there again. Those who did not understand, I just repeat once again. These are the equations. Read the question well. When you read the question, a train starting from rest. From this, you are getting a clue. That is, here U is zero. Attains a velocity of 72. That means zero it started. Now it is having velocity 72. How much time? In 5 minutes. Now you can find out the acceleration. There is no change in velocity. It is moving with the same velocity. So apply the first equation of motion. Before that, we need to convert this into meter per second, since we need to use SI unit. So when you convert, this is we have learned, multiply with the 5 by 18. When you get 5 by 18, you are getting the answer in velocity in meter per second. Time was 5 minutes, we converted into 300. Now we substituted all these values here. Then we got the answer 1 by 50. Okay. Now we have to find out the distance. So for distance, go back to the equations. Use, find out which are the equations we can use to find out S. When you saw both equations are suitable. So which is more convenient for you, which is not much complicated, use it. Since U square going to be zero, so it is more easy to access this equation. So that's why I used that. You can also use that equation and check whether you are getting the answer. Same answer you will get. Okay. So apply here. 20 square is equal to 2 by 15 into S. 15. Cross multiply. We get like this. S 3000 meter. Clear? So this is how to solve. Clear? Students, are you all okay with it?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So don't worry. We will practice more problems in remaining session. Now, related to this, we need to have some cases, are there special cases. Here it is, now acceleration is positive. When acceleration become negative, what happened to this relation? So far we were discussing about motion on a road. Objects not only moving on a road, it also moving upward and downward, correct? A mango falling down. Now jackfruit and mango season, it's falling in your home. There are mango trees, it is just falling. That is a motion. So in that case, how can we utilize this equation? So that is the special cases. So first case, case one, when object is moving upwards. So far we have not discussed this one because there's a chapter known as gravitation coming up. So there we will learn much detail, but in this we need to have some problems. For that purpose I am teaching you. When an object is moving upwards. Okay. So when an object is moving upwards, the motion of an object is against the gravity. It is against the gravity or gravitational force. So this is a situation like this. You are moving upwards and someone is pulling you backward. What will happen to your motion? Arjun, what do you think so? When you are moving upward, some of your friends are catching hold of your leg and pulling you down. What will happen to the speed of your motion?
It will slow down.
Slow down. That means velocity decreases. So in this case, what is happening? Once velocity decreases, gradually acceleration is going to be negative. Correct? So when an object is moving upwards, velocity decreases. As we go further and further, we reach to a particular height. Just imagine you are going upwards and someone is going and pulling down. You try very hard and reach to a particular height. And you cannot go beyond that, because the person who is pulling you harder than your motion or faster your motion, gradually what will happen? You start falling down. Okay, this is what happens. So as we move upon, gravitational forces acting against your motion. Whenever object is moving upwards, gravitational force is acting against your motion in opposite direction. So your speed reduces. The speed reduces in such a way that at a particular height it becomes zero. So when an object moves upwards, because of gravitational force, its velocity decreases and it reaches up to a particular height, it becomes fully zero. That's the time it starts falling. Just imagine if I drop this tiles, okay? You know, it falls a particular height and it falls down. So this is the reason when I throw it, earth is pulling and it reaches particular height. Its velocity becomes zero. That's why it start falling. Okay. So this is the case one. So in this case, acceleration is negative. So when an object is moving upwards, acceleration is negative because velocity decreases. Why? Because of gravitational force. Gravitational force pushing that object in downward. So naturally it will become. Okay. So in that case, what will happen to three equation of motion? Here, acceleration of motion become acceleration due to gravity G. The value of G is earth standard value. Earth is pulling, no? That's why we are using acceleration due to gravity. We have learned in 8th standard chapter force. Do you remember pressure?
Yes, ma'am.
Factor. In that we have learned factors affecting pressure. One is acceleration due to gravity. Its value is 9.8. It is approximately equal to 10. Easy for to calculate. We can use 10. It's a standard value. Now, what happened to G? G is going to be negative. When an object is moving upwards, acceleration become negative. And since displacement going upwards, so instead of displacement, we use the letter H. Even you don't use it, no problem. But I'm just telling you, because it's a height we measure. When you talk about the displacement of an object moving upwards, actually it is the height of that object. Clear? At what height it is falling down. Therefore, our first equation of motion become u minus gt. Second equation of motion, h is equal to just we displace. We just replace between A. That's all. Same thing only, but situation is different. So it become, instead of 2As, here we are getting minus. Why? Here, velocity decreases. So acceleration. So acceleration is negative. So V become zero. It is one more thing. final velocity v. V means final velocity v become zero. Yeah. Okay. Any doubt? I repeat this case. Then object is moving upwards. The motion is against the gravitational force. So due to that gravitational force, velocity decreases, and when it reaches to a particular height, the final velocity becomes zero. And at that particular point, an object starts falling. At that particular point, an object starts falling. Okay, children, you don't have to by heart this equation. I would say that's a wrong idea to by heart. Why? Because it gives you confusion. You just understand this situation and the cases. In this case, what will happen to the acceleration? What will happen to v? If you understand that, when you do the problem, you just apply that, you will get the correct equations. Otherwise, what will happen? No, you get confused with the minus and plus. Only learn this. These are the tips. Okay, so learn that three equation what I taught. Learn this condition. According to that, you use it. Clear? Okay. Similarly, another case. Case two. Object is moving downwards. So it will be just opposite, correct? When an object moves downwards, velocity increases. Velocity increases. Why? It is in the direction of gravitational. Ah. So Earth doesn't have to pull you hard. You automatically fall down. Okay. Velocity increases due to the motion in the direction of gravity or gravitational force. So gradually what will become? From where are you falling? At a particular height. At particular height, v is zero. Now, if you talk about an object is falling down, that v is the one now becoming initial velocity for this. Are you getting me the idea? When object reaches to a particular height, final velocity becomes zero. It starts falling. Therefore, an object is falling in the direction of gravitational force downwards, that v is the one acting like a u for it. That's why I have given u is equal to 0 meter per second. So gradually what will happen? Acceleration is positive. So acceleration is positive. So if you just learn this condition, we will able to solve the problems. Clear? So this is the reason whenever an object falls down, maybe a coconut fall down or a mango fall down or maybe an apple fell down. Suppose the height is too much. Naturally, once it hit on the floor, apple can break into two, or mangoes can become little bit, one side must be little cut open or whatever it is. Clear? Because the impact of the falling is too much. That's why some of you falling down from a particular height, fractured, your bones got fractured, some will die. You know, some of them will commit suicide by jumping from the floor because of this impact. You are coming with the maximum speed. As you go upward, you are slowing down. But when you fall, your movement is coming with maximum velocity. With that impact, you are hitting on the floor. Naturally, death can take place or you will have a fractured body. Yeah? Okay, so that's why this impact is too much. Because it is in the gravitational force. Once it hit the floor, again, it loses some energy. So you will be slowing down. But till it hit that moment, velocity is maximum. Okay, student. So now we're winding up the session today. So understand these two conditions so that next time we can have problems based on it.
Yes,
thank you, students.
Thank you.